Hello, I am Luis Nuño. I am a professor in the area of signal theory and communications at the Polytechnic University of Valencia in Spain. Now I'm going to explain what is the spectrum of a sound, and I will show some spectra of different sounds. We will start with very simple sounds, which are electronic, such as the PR tone and the real tone, and then other periodic signals, such as triangle, square, sawtooth, and a new one developed by me called armchair. The spectrum has two characteristics, the magnitude and the phase. We will explain what's the envelope of a sound and how it affects the spectrum. We will consider different types of envelopes, plane, triangular, linearly decreasing, and also oscillating amplitude and frequency. Then we will show the spectra of real instruments such as the piano and violin, and we will finish with some conclusions. This is the PR tone for C4, this is the sound. It has been represented on a time axis. This is the waveform. Its length is called period. For a C4, it is 3.8 milliseconds. The amplitude is here normalized from -1 to +1. The inverse of the period is the frequency. For a C4, it is 260 Hz. This is the spectrum, the representation of the sound on a frequency axis. Now the amplitude has been normalized from 0 to 1. If the length of the tone is infinite, then the spectrum is a very thin line. But in the case of a real tone with a finite length, for example, this is a whole note for quarter note equal to 90, the length is 2.667 seconds. We have represented them here, but because there are near 700 periods, we cannot appreciate the waveform, but only the maximum and minimum values. This is called the envelope. In this case, the spectrum is not a very thin line, but something like this. The width of the main part of the line is 2 divided by the length, which is 0.75 Hz. Now let's consider other periodic signals, some of them very simple, such as the triangle. This is a C4, and a square. The sawtooth. And now a bit more complex signal developed by me, which I call armchair. Let's listen to its sound. Let's consider the last one as a reference to obtain the spectrum. In this case, the spectrum contains not only one line, but several lines. These frequencies are F, 260 Hz, 2 times F, 3 times F, etc. So multiples of F. The distance between two consecutive lines is F as well. Now, each of that line has the same shape as the one in the tone, with the same length. So the width of the main part of the line is, again, 0.75 Hz. When we have several tones, as in this case, another concept appears, which is the phase. Here we have three tones. The first one has the maximum located here, but the other maximums are located at different times. These differences are called the phases of the tones. Usually we will represent on the spectrum only the magnitude and not the phases. But which is the effect of the phase? Here we have an example with three harmonics with different amplitudes and phases. And then the three harmonics with the same amplitudes, but we change the phases. So let's try to distinguish between the two sounds. The waveforms are different, but the sounds are practically the same. So in this case, the phase didn't affect the sound, but in other cases, it does. Now let's study the effect of the envelope. This is a plain envelope. This is a whole note. For quarter note equal to 90, this is a tone. As we saw, the spectrum is a line whose width is 2 divided by the length, 0.75 Hz. For the armchair, the same length. We have several lines, each of them is equal to the one in the tone. Let's divide the length by 8, so this is an eighth note for a tone. Now, the width of the line is 2 divided by the length, which is 6 Hz. And in the case of the armchair, we have several lines. Each of them is equal to the one in the tone. Let's divide again the length of the sound by 8. This is the result. Now, the width of the line is 48 Hz. And here, in the case of the armchair, we can appreciate an overlap here. And let's divide again by 8 the length of the sound. This is the result. Now the width of the line is near 400 Hz, and in the case of the armchair we have a full overlap. Now let's consider a triangular envelope. This is crescendo and decrescendo, as can be done, for example, with a violin or with a wind instrument. This is the tone. In this case, the spectral line has a width which is double than in the previous case, that is 4 divided by the length, 1.5 Hz. And in the case of the armchair, with crescendo and decrescendo, we have several lines. Each of them is equal to the one in the tone. Now, a linearly decreasing envelope, that is only the decrescendo, as occurs, for example, with a piano or a guitar. This is the tone. Now, this is the shape of the spectral line, and the armchair. It contains several lines, each of them is equal to the one in the tone. And now let's consider an oscillating amplitude, that is a vibrato. In this case is 5 Hz in this direction, and the variation in amplitude is plus minus 25% in this direction. This is the result for the tone. Now the spectral line contains two small lines, 5 Hz apart, 5 Hz because the vibrato was 5 Hz. And in the case of the armchair, again we have several lines, each of them contains two small lines, as in the case of the tone. And now let's consider an oscillating frequency, a vibrato of 5 Hz, and a variation in frequency of plus minus 33 cents. This is the tone. Now the spectral lines contains several smaller lines, 5 Hz apart, as in the vibrato frequency. In the case of the armchair, we have several lines, each of them is equal to the one in the tone. And now let's consider real instruments. This is a piano generated by Finale program with Garrett Instruments. This is a stereo sound, that means that we receive two signals, one with one ear, the left channel, and another signal with the other ear, which is the right channel. So we perceive two different signals at the same time. Technically, if we want to convert the stereo sound into a mono sound, what we do is to sum the two channels. This is the result. In each case, we can see that the envelope is a bit different. And the waveform also changes with time. We will see the waveform for different times. This is for t equals 0.5 seconds, left channel, right channel, and the sum. For t equals 1 second, left channel, right, and the sum. And for t equals 1.5 seconds, left, right, and the sum. Well, as we can see, the waveform changes with time. And now let's listen to a violin. This is the stereo sound, the left channel, the right channel, and the sum. And now the waveform also changes with time. Let's see the waveform for time equal to 0.5 seconds, the left channel, right channel, and the sum, for t equal 1 second, and for t equal 1.5 seconds. So in all cases, the waveform changes with time. Now these are the spectrum for the piano. It contains several lines, but each of them is quite complex. And in the case of the violin, each line, as we can see, contains an oscillating frequency. And the shape of the line is really complex. As conclusions, the spectrum of a pure tone is aligned with width 0. The spectrum of a real tone with length L is aligned with width 2 divided by the length L. The spectrum of a periodic signal with frequency f is a series of lines or harmonics with frequencies f, 2f, 3f, etc. If the waveform is not constant, the harmonics are complex. The waveform of a real instrument changes with time, not only the shape but also the amplitude and frequency, so its harmonics are very complex. You can find all the information on the webpage harmonicwheel.com. Thank you very much for your attention.